Well, at lunchtime today, a few could have predicted what a magnificent finish this test match was going to produce. England victorious by an innings, thanks to 4 wickets from Swan, 4 from Trenlett and 2 from Stuart Broad. Indeed, Captain Andrew Strauss had earlier let Ian Bell reach the magical 3 figures before declaring, and then England really went about their business with a real killer instinct, and that was what pleased Strauss most.
But, you know, I was really impressed by the intensity the guys showed, because in those circumstances you can just come out and go through the motions a bit. I think, you know, right from ball one, the 2 seamers set the tone really well. They're backed up well on the field. And, you know, it's a tricky period of time to bat 50-odd overs as a batting side with not much to gain. And if you can get early wickets, then pressure starts to play a pretty big part, and that's what we did. And once we got the pressure on, we managed to... Yeah, sniff out the victory pretty well from there on.
Yeah, obviously it's everyone came to the ground today with the intention of trying to get a result out of the game. You know, we were very focused, throughout the day, and when we had the opportunity to do that, obviously Bailey got his 100, which was great knock, and then we were able to put a little bit of pressure. It was perfect the amount of time we had before tea, where we could have the open bowlers could have a burst and then come back and refresh and have another go. And you know, the way Tremlett and all 3 of them bowled really in the partnership was fantastic.
As I said, I was very impressed by that. I thought we showed quite a lot of ruthlessness in Australia, and this was a good example of that for me as well.
For Sri Lanka, they'll have to pick themselves up somehow. Dilshan, the new young captain, will have to find a way of really re-galvanising his troops ahead of the next test match at Lord's, which starts in just 3 days' time.
Very difficult to explain, definitely. I also can't believe we got out from 24 overs, such a good batting lineup we got, but unfortunately we lost the match because of we didn't bat really badly today.
It's one of those situations where the full pressure of test match cricket comes to bear quite quickly on a team, and you need guys to stand up and get past that, and thankfully we were good enough to make sure that their batsmen weren't able to do that.
They think they played really good cricket the last few years, last few 6-7 months. They beat in Australia, beat Australia here. We can't say straight away for today's performance they are the best team. We wait and see what happened the next couple of test matches.
So England start the summer victorious. They've now won 4 tests out of 5 by an innings. They're really displaying that killer instinct that's so important to be number 1 in the world. They need to go to Lord's and continue this good start, and they'll be hoping to do so. But they'll have to do so without Jimmy Anderson. A slight side strain means he's out. However, there's plenty of options for England to bring in. Maybe Stephen Finn with his height, maybe Ajmal Shahzad with the swing, or perhaps a return for Graham Onions, who's been out of international cricket for so long now. Whatever this week brings, England have started well, and the Sri Lankans have really got to produce something special to get back in this series. Bonnie Douglas for ECB Online, in a very sunny now, Cardiff.